The big deal about toxins is that toxins are anything foreign to the body that are electron stealers and make the body sick. So toxins have several categories. There are microbial toxins such as viruses, bacteria. You have heavy metal toxins. You have chemical toxins and you have airborne toxins. Again, all these things are electron stealers for the body and they make the body sick so that the body does not repair and heal like it should. At the Tennant Institute, how we treat toxins is that we figured out that toxins actually work at what's called the biophysics level. A lot of times that people are looking at toxins and they're trying to treat them as if they work at the biochemistry level, we figured out that they work at what's called the biophysics level. So that's how we're able to treat them. Each toxin in this world, whether it be a chemical toxin, metal toxin, microbial toxin, every toxin has its own frequency it runs under. We've been able to digitize antidote frequencies and treat them in the body so that the body can efficiently remove these toxins. One of the best things you can do in preparation for the appointment is filling out the paperwork. The paperwork helps us get a good history so that we can pinpoint what toxins might be causing some of your issues. So as we get the history and we get more info on voltage and oligoscan readings, which test for heavy metals, we're able to get enough information to be able to test you to see which toxins are specifically affecting your body. Once we've figured out which toxins are affecting your body, we use an advanced waveform called scalar energy to be able to drive in these antidote frequencies into your system. How mercury affects the body is that you get multiple sources of mercury exposure. A lot of people have amalgam fillings or metal fillings in their mouth. Other sources of mercury are in fish. When they would burn coal off the seacoast, a lot of the fish would absorb the mercury. So there are various mechanisms for getting mercury in your body, but one of the things I see it affects on patients is their brain and their brain function. So as you properly detox the mercury out of the system, you see great results in the brain function. There are four ways that you can reduce toxic load in the body. One of them is simple patient education. You know, a lot of people don't know they're running into these toxicities or getting exposure to them. And so just by simply educating on you on where you get these exposures, you can avoid a lot. Second is actually nose breathing. The nose is actually the best filter in the body. Whenever you're mouth breathing, you're actually absorbing more toxicities. When you breathe through the nose, there are multiple layers of filters there to properly take the toxins and eliminate them later. Third thing you can do is there are many different things you can use to be able to help avoid some of the toxicities. There's certain air filters out there, water filters. We've tested multiple ones and we've found some of the best to help you avoid toxins in the air and water, which are very common. Fourth, simply keeping your voltages up. If you keep your body's voltage up, then your body's going to recognize a toxin and be able to properly eliminate it. Otherwise, if your voltage is low, the toxin likes to stay in the body, causing more damage.